guys, welcome back to another video. So in this one, we're gonna be comparing a cheap little solar controller that I picked up from Vic Off-Road to our permanent Victron Energy solar setup in the ute. Let's get straight into it. Now keep in mind guys, this is only going to be a comparison of the power output of the two units. I'm not gonna be comparing the units in price or any other sort of build quality. It's just gonna be the power output and what you can get out of these two units side by side. Also guys, after watching, if you are interested in purchasing one of these units, I will leave links down in the description box below where you can find the cheapest price for each of the units. Okay, it might be a little bit hard to show you, but that's why camera might be a little bit wobbly. But if you guys have watched any of our videos before, you would know that I love our Victron charging gear. So I'll spin you guys around so you can have a look. We've got the DC-DC charger and the MPPT controller. Now, this unit, solar charge controller, is a 20 amp unit, as is the little cheap ATEMPOWER one. So the rules are gonna be pretty simple. Our system runs our solar through a regulator, through a shunt, and then into the R120X Pro battery down here. So it's gonna be very easy to monitor. We're not gonna take any readings from this Bluetooth unit. We're gonna take all of our readings from the shunt just before the battery here, and we're gonna just compare the two readings of both solar controllers. So let's get straight into it. I've made sure that everything else is turned off on the other side of the canopy, but let's turn the solar charge controller on and see exactly how much power we're putting in. So this is what I love about this Victron unit as well. It's so easy to use and muck around with settings and things like that and customize to any setup that you want. All right, so you guys should be able to see that on screen now. We're putting in around that 4.5 amp mark. Pretty good, around 60 watts. So what we're gonna do is just leave this run for 5 minutes and see what the average is. So I'm just gonna keep a close eye on this and I'll time lapse this so you don't have to sit here 5 minutes watching it, but we'll see what this does over 5 minutes and then we'll swap the regulators and see what the other one does. So hopefully you guys saw the value really didn't change that much. It was just floating around that 4.5, 4.6 amps going into the battery. So pretty good result. For 110 watts, I think it was putting in, average of about 60, which is pretty good. It's only fairly early, it's only 10:30. The sun's not all the way up in the sky yet. So it's not too bad of a result, to be honest, with the Victron unit. So let's swap over to the ATEMPOWER unit and see how that one goes. Now, all I've got to do is chuck the fuse back in and this little unit should start charging automatically. So I'll get the shunt ready. I'll bang this fuse back in and then straight away, we've got the ATEMPOWER regulator hooked up and it's charging away now. So we're sitting at 4.78 amps. So pretty good. It's actually better than the Victron was. Not by much, only by what, 0.2 of an amp. So bugger, it could just be that it's a little bit brighter. It's been 20 minutes changing it over from one to the other. So that's pretty incredible though, that it's doing the same if not better than the expensive Victron charger. But anyway, we'll leave it for 5 minutes again and come back to it and see what it's done. Far out. All right, so I'll just jump in, compare the trends now. I reckon we're gonna be pretty surprised, to be honest. All right, so I'll cut this on the screen now so you guys can see it as well, but I'll just jump into the trends and go for the last 5 minutes and we'll compare voltage and current. So you guys can see there, if I just take that back along the line, and I'll just zoom right in. So if you look at the trend here, this is the Victron unit over the 5 minutes. So it started there, ramped up to 4.2, 4.3, 4.4, and then sort of topped out and leveled out at 5.5. And the voltage was just ever so slowly climbing up, 13.33, 34, and then we turned it off and changed it over. So we'll just jump forward here to, I'm not sure what's happened with the shunt, but this has actually been the case for the whole test. It shot up to 4.6 and 13.39 volts, and it's just held that for the whole 5 minutes. And sorry, up until right there, it's gone to 4.7 amps. And I actually did see it get to 4.8 as well. So that's actually pretty cool. This cheap little solar controller for as has outdone the Victron one. I don't actually think I believe it. I'm gonna go back and change it over again. I'm gonna do this test one more time. So we'll change back over, do the Victron again, because it might just be, as the sun's coming up, we're getting more coverage on the panel. So I just wanna make sure that's the case, that this little charge is not that much better than this Victron one. But anyway, I'll change them over, we'll do the test one more time, and we'll have a look at the results. All right, so I've just swapped it back over again. I've made sure that we are definitely on the Victron. Now, I'll just jump into the Victron app. I'll cut this on the screen so you guys can follow along with what I'm doing. Let's go back into the shunt, see what that's doing. All right, so you can see on the screen there, guys, that it's just over 5 amps. So I think it probably is that the sun's just coming up, so it's getting a bit more exposure as the day goes on. So that's probably why it seemed like the other one was performing better than the Victron. But in saying that, I'd go so far as to say that the ATEMPOWER was at least on par with the Victron unit. It was at least doing just as good of a job. So that actually is really impressive. All right, we'll swap it over one more time. That's the number for right now. So the Victron is up to just over 5 amps, 5.03, we'll call it 5 amp. If this little ATEMPOWER can crack 5 amps right now, I'll be really blown away. All right, so there it is on the screen. That's the ATEMPOWER MPPT controller. 4.97 amps. Are you serious? It's 4.98. It's close enough to 5. We'll call it 5 amps. The difference between the output is that small that you would never notice it. It wouldn't matter what you were running. You would not notice that in your solar system. I am absolutely blown away. I can't believe that is putting out the same amount of power as my expensive Victron unit. And oh, mate, far out, man. If you're looking to build a budget solar setup, I don't think you could look past one of these little ATEMPOWER charge controllers, because that has blown me away. ATEMPOWER or Vic Off-Road, they haven't paid me to say any of this. I just was really curious to see how this went. Righto, so that actually surprised me a fair bit. The little ATEMPOWER regulator, it blew my expectations away, honest to God. But in saying that, would I swap that for my Victron smart shunt? No, I probably wouldn't. It doesn't have all the fancy bells and whistles that the Victron one does. It doesn't have the Bluetooth. It doesn't have complete customizable settings that you can change for any purpose that you see fit. It does have a lot of stuff missing that the Victron one does have. But in saying that, if you are looking for a budget-friendly, good quality charge controller that is MPPT and lithium compatible, then you've got to check this one out. Because when it all boils down to it, it comes down to what your regulator is going to put into your battery. And that thing just stacked up really bloody well. Also, guys, I'll quickly overlay this on the screen now, but have a look at what I've got set up here. I've got a little sneaky mod for this battery that I think you guys are really going to love. So that'll be coming out hopefully in the coming weeks. But let me know in the comments what you think this battery is going to be powering, because that about wraps up the output comparison for the two charge controllers. Let me know in the comments what you guys would go with if you are in the market for one, if you're looking more towards the budget end, or if you're looking towards the upper, you know, Victron end. Let me know in the comments. I'd be really keen to hear exactly what you guys are thinking after that little comparison on the output. All right, guys, get out and about. We'll see you in the next one.